This is the Michael Jackson commercial that everybody's been waiting to see. The filming almost turned into a disaster as Michael Jackson was set on fire by the very pyrotechnics that were designed to highlight the commercial. Tonight, we'll be talking to the man who directed the shoot, Bob Giraldi, about his work with Michael Jackson, Paul McCartney, Pat Benatar, and Lionel Richie. And for the first time anywhere in the world, we'll show you Michael Jackson's Pepsi commercial.
Things and processes in my life, and this form came along that allowed me to tell stories a new way, and I enjoy that. I think it's more exciting than doing a feature film. We were in that bar, the Hard Rock Cafe. Let's just call it a scouting trip in the world of film. But I wanted Michael to come along because the areas were so dangerous. And Michael walked in, and some old drunken lady I saw and said, "And Michael Jack, Michael!" And being the hero he is, got off that stool and came to him, followed by maybe 20, 25 people, one by one. "Mike, Jack, Michael, oh, Mike!" And that kind of thing. "And Jack, hey, Jack, whoa, what?" And before you know it, everybody was there. And here we were, the eight of us, looking like this. Michael never moved. It was an interesting experience for Michael. But the experience turned out to be a nice experience because all I wanted to do was feel and touch and see a superstar. And they reached out and touched him, and Michael touched him back. And it was the first time that I saw some sort of mystical thing happening between him and people. And it was a nice, what was a scary moment turned out to be a nice moment, you know?
How many days of shooting to do Beat It?
Two nights. They weren't considered days. Long, hard nights. And somewhere around 3 o'clock in the morning, you question whether you even want to stay any longer, but you stay and you get it.
And then editing?
Oh, editing was a 2 weeks or so, but editing process is so difficult with adding music and sound effects and all. I mean, I'm excited about the fact that it was one of the first videos that used the track and had sound. I mean, it would not be anywhere near as exciting as those doors in the factory, you know.
If the fight scene in Beat It seems remarkably real, it's because Giraldi didn't only use actors. He added actual street gangs as extras.
And that was the most amazing experience that I've had in filmmaking. Because Michael Jackson, Michael Peters, Vincent Patterson, me and the cameras, dancers, and all of these street gangs are watching. And before you know it, the first time we do it, pop, the top, boom, dancing, they don't usually dance. But they saw something happening in their brothers. And I know in their bodies and their minds, they said to themselves, "Now that's macho. Now we may be tough, you know, we may take your eyes off, but we can't dance like that." And the more they danced, and by the 10th take, the thing was so hot. Everybody came from everywhere, and I never forget the smoke in that factory, you know, in that warehouse, and those doors opening. I mean, it was really hot, and there was not one bit of trouble.
Finished, and you and Michael were looking at it together. Did you or Michael know you had a winner on your hands?
Yes. I mean, I can't. You can be humbled and say, but you know what? It's hot. Mm-hmm. Michael Peters had a party. The choreographer had a party. Two nights later, and I was in Los Angeles, and I took the cassette. I went to a party, which was predominantly black, and played it. And the party was in one room, the dancing was in one room, and everybody stayed in that room, and they must have played it 75 times. And we knew. I mean, you can know. You know, damn. You know, whoa, one more time. You know, I mean, it's hot. It's a hot. You know, we're at a time when things like that have a great appeal, and that has a good appeal.
Just be there.
with the incredible impact that Beat It had, were you a bit disappointed when you found out that Michael Jackson had chosen John Landis to do Thriller?
Mm-hmm. I think all creative people who have egos would be disappointed, but I think the choice to choose John for that kind of piece that he had had experience in Werewolf, and he's a fine, fine major league director, and I think their collaboration is wonderful.
Beat It, directed by you, Thriller by Landis, both had these dramatic manhole scenes.
The manhole scenes are Michael's. That was one of the scenes, and in Beat It, he suggested, he always wanted to do that. In fact, he bothered me. He said, Bob, when are we doing the manhole? And I kept looking for him. You know, manhole's not that easy to find, especially ones you can go down with a schedule that tight. But we found it and did it, and that might end up being his trademark. He may do Peter Pan and have a manhole scene, I don't know, but effective scenes, you know.
Get even further with the opening scene of Say, Say, Say.
I'll try one.
Here's a young gentleman. Like to try one. Yes, sir. Yeah. Drink it up. Let me help you with that, my friend.
I wanted to work with someone that Michael would be comfortable with. You know, because sometimes you can get a brainwave and think, so-and-so would be great. Fellini, wow. Yeah. Now he would be good. But I mean, you can think, and you get him, and he agrees to do it. But some of the chemistry can go wrong. So I knew Bob had worked with Michael. Bob Giraldi, who directed it, had worked with Michael. And so I thought, and I liked his work. I wanted to work with him. So it seemed to fit, yeah. He came over and he had this feeling of Michael and I working together, which is kind of a free feeling. He wanted to communicate this sort of freedom of, like, you know, easy rider, you know, get out.
Say, say, say what you want, but don't play games with my affection. Take, take, take what you need, but don't leave me with no direction.
Did the Say, Say, Say video cost $300,000?
Ouch. Why would I? Well, I don't want to talk about money less. I mean, it costs around that. Film is expensive. I know that young people that give you tapes and all would suggest that maybe it doesn't have to be quite as expensive as it is. But I'm around a lot of, you know, kind of cameramen and the prop people and whatever. My film costs close to $100,000 a day, unless there's a good reason for not. And Paul and Michael are superstars. We have to do things right. I think the video suggests that it's an expensive video. I think it's I'm getting around that subject as best I can, because that's not really for me to. I don't want to disclose.
But
what is not
but
my.
It's in the press. I mean, it's in Time Magazine. It's
close.
It's in every newspaper.
It's close.
I mean,
it's probably a little more.
More than 300.
Who said that?
First time you've ever admitted that, you know. Forget the money. Okay, fine. You spent $327,000. But here you are on the set. You have these two superstars, Michael Jackson and Paul McCartney, and let's don't leave out Bob Giraldi. There's three pretty large egos. How was that?
It's phenomenal. I mean, that's an incredible experience. Paul has his camper and his entourage, and Michael has his camper and his entourage, and I have my camper and my entourage. And we came together beautifully. I've since made a statement in the press, which I don't think anybody was too pleased with, that because it always gets edited in the press, I hope, you know, that there's only one star in my set, meaning that when time comes to work, right, there's no stars and no star catering. They do their job, they do their jobs, I do mine, mm-hmm. And it's all business. By the way, I think one of the magical moments is when Paul puts shaving cream on Michael's face, and Michael didn't know that was coming. That was when Paul and I went over to the side and said, on this take, why don't you try just going right across your face and go onto him and see what happens.